Hello guys! Today is the first day of the Sephora sale. I am so excited. I just got off work and I have been itching to get to Sephora, but unfortunately I had to work today. I just got off. I'm heading to the store. I have had my wish list ready for like the past couple of weeks, so I'm excited to pick these items up and then we are gonna do a haul. So let's go to Sephora and hopefully we can find some good stuff. Let's go shopping. Hello my friends, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a wonderful day today. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you a huge Sephora haul. Today is the first day of the Sephora savings event. If you are a Rouge member, you can save 20%. If you're a VIB, you can save 15%. And if you're a Beauty Insider, you can save 10%. It is a tiered program, so make sure to check the description box. I'll have all the details of dates of when you can shop. But I am a Rouge member, so I was able to save 20%. Like I said, today is the first day. So I went into store and I bought a bunch of things. There were a couple things I wasn't able to get in store, so stay tuned and make sure you're subscribed. There may be a part two because you guys, when the Sephora sale comes around and you can save 20% on all of these items, you just can't resist sometimes. So I picked up a lot of really good things. I have some restocks, some new products, and honestly, I also went into store too, and there were some things that I had on my list, but when I saw it in person, I ended up not getting it. So let's go ahead. We have a big bag here. We're gonna just get right into it. Okay, so the first item I picked up was this Beauty Blender Power Pocket Puff. Now this is actually a restock for me, but I wanted to freshen up and get a new one. This is amazing for powder. So a lot of times what I do is, hold on, let me try to open it here, is when I apply my translucent powder to set my concealer, I will use this little powder puff, and it's perfect because it has a little holder for your finger and you can very easily get underneath of your eye. It is great. I love using this. This was $18 and then I saved 20%, but again, you know, the one that I have, it's gotten kind of crusty and I've tried to wash it and sometimes you just need to get a fresh one. So I got this. Then, sticking with that, this is another item I love, and it is the Beauty Blender Besties Iconic. So you can just get the Beauty Blender alone, which is $20, or you can pay a couple bucks extra. I always pay a couple bucks extra to get this little kit because you essentially get the makeup sponge, you get a blender cleanser solid, you get a silicone scrub mat, a primer sample, and then you get this little pouch, which I'll open it so I can show you. It's a little pouch that I love using for travel because anytime you travel, you know how your beauty blender can get a little funky after using it. So this is great because it has two little compartments, one where you put your beauty sponge and then the other one if you want to put, like if you want to put the puff on the other side, you can. And then it has this little solid where you can use to clean your beauty blender. But I love the pink beauty blender. I've tried a lot of the other colors, but I don't know if I've mentioned to you before, but I feel like there's nothing like the original. I can notice a difference in consistency when I use other colors, so I really like the pink one. So restocked on that. This was a new item, and if I end up picking up an item and I like got a recommendation from someone, I'll make sure to mention their name. But I love Whitney Rife on Instagram. She's a fashion blogger. Her style, I would say we're very similar in the sense where we love color. I've mentioned her before, but in one of her Instagram stories, she mentioned this Glossier You perfume, and she said that anytime she wears it, she gets a ton of compliments. So let me show you what it looks like. So here is the bottle right here. It is pink with a red top. And I would say this is just a really nice, like, fresh scent. I can't really think of another scent that it reminds me of, but she said that every time she wears it, she gets a ton of compliments, and she described it as like an everyday scent. So if you're going in your closet and you just want to spray something but you don't want it to be too overpowering, she was like, this is a good one. So I definitely wanted to pick it up, and it really wasn't that pricey either. So I picked that up, and there is a larger size, but I just ended up getting the 1.7 fluid ounces. Okay, sticking with fragrances, this is a repurchase. I think I've purchased this now 3 or 4 times, and this was initially recommended by Jaclyn Hill, and it is the Fenty Skin Butter Drop. This smells like a cinnamon roll in your, it really does. So essentially what I'll do is I will take a shower, you know, shave my legs in the shower, and then when I get out, I will take this cream, and it smells so good, I swear. It's cinnamon, warm cinnamon, so it's probably more of like a wintry scent, I would say, because it kind of reminds me a little of the holidays, but it smells so yummy if you like those dessert-type fragrance scents. So I love this. It's a nice whipped texture, but again, it is a little pricey, like $30-some, so if I can save 20%, I have to get it. Plus, it's like always out of stock, so if I ever see it in the store, it's like one of those things where if I see it, I gotta add it to my basket. The next item, this is something I didn't plan on purchasing, because if you're familiar with me and my channel, I love the Benefit Bad Gal Bang Mascara. That is my favorite. I also love the Gucci mascara, but when I went in store, the sales associate actually recommended this to me, and it's by Tower 28. It's the Make Waves mascara. So I am always, I'll be honest, I like the Bad Gal Bang so much that I'm always a little reluctant to get a new one because I'm like, there's no way I'm gonna like it. But a lot of people have raved about it. So here is the packaging. Again, it's by Tower 28. I've never tried anything from Tower 28, but I wanna show you the, oh, I might like this. So the wand is the plastic wand, and you can see it is curved. So let me see. I'm using the viewfinder here, so it's probably not going to be the best, but I'm going to try this out and I'll let you know. But people have raved about this, so I'm excited to try this. Then this got me as I was in line, and it is the Sephora Moisturizing Cleansing Wipes, and this was in watermelon. I don't know if watermelon is a new scent, or maybe this is just different packaging. I feel like they used to have a turquoise packaging for this, but I love these makeup wipes. I usually use the Neutrogena, but you can never have too many of these. So what I'll do is I'll wash my face, you know, get all my makeup off, and then this is like the final step before I apply my moisturizer, my serum, all that, just to make sure I get all the makeup, because I love foundation and powder, and that can really cake up, and if I don't get all my makeup off, then I'm going to break out for sure. And this is really good too when it comes to like getting your eye makeup off. Now again, my favorite are the Neutrogena, but I saw these and I'm like, they were $6, you can save 20%, so I picked that up. It was one of those items that got me when I was in the checkout. All right, what else here? Okay, this is another item. I was not planning on purchasing this, but I was just perusing through Sephora. I was in there for an hour, and I saw this. It is by Lawless, and I've never purchased anything from the brand Lawless, but I thought this was pretty. It is the Maximal Lip, wait, no, sorry. Forget the Filler Lip Plumping Line Smoothing Gloss, and I got the shade Velvet, and there were a couple other shades as well, but here is the packaging. It comes in like the frosted glass, and we are going to try this on. Ooh, it's a little goopy. Oh, it has a nice little fruity scent. Now, I have to be careful because the last time I tried on a gloss, I had lipstick on my teeth for the rest of the video, so I have to be careful. I'm just going to put a little here. Oh my goodness. I love this. It's so funny. You go into Sephora and sometimes the items that you end up loving aren't the things that you actually went in to get. Oh, I love this. They had other colors. I might have to pick them up. Again, Lawless Plumping, Smoothing, Nourishing. I got it in the shade Velvet. Check the description. I will link everything down below. This, I love it. Okay. There's more. Okay, this is an item that I typically purchase during the Nordstrom anniversary sale because you get two for essentially the price of one, but I could get 20% off. So I got the Vitamin Enriched Face Base. Now, I usually get the big one, but I ended up getting a little baby because my daughter has started using mine, so I thought I could get her one of these as well. This is so good. It combines as a moisturizer and a primer. Now I'll use it as a moisturizer and then I will still put a primer on in addition to that, but this is such a good moisturizer. I would highly recommend it. My daughter has, you know, had little like dry patches lately and she's used this and as soon as she puts it on, it clears it up. So I got the little one. The big one is so expensive. The big one was like, I don't know, 60 some dollars. It used to be 60, and during the sale you could get two for 60, and now it is like 67. So I get the smaller one, which was like 20 some bucks, but this is really good if you're looking for a good moisturizer to try. I have been loving this concealer. It is the Dior Forever Skin Correct, and it's a very creamy formula, and it's not as heavy as a lot of other concealers. I get it in 2N. It comes in this little packaging. I just love this. Again, it's not as heavy as some of the other concealers that I've used, so I really like this. So since I could save 20%, now is the time to restock because it is 40 bucks, which is a little pricey for a concealer, but it's really, really good. I am getting older, you guys. I have a lot of fine lines and wrinkles. I do not have Botox or anything like that, so I have to do whatever possible to try to make sure that the products I use don't seep into my fine lines, and I find that I really like that concealer a lot. It does a good job of not just settling in, so I love that. Oh, okay. This next product is a product I have probably heard everyone and their mother talk about, and I am just now jumping on the bandwagon. And you would think that I would have been on the bandwagon because I'm kind of funny about my skin when it comes to going into the sun. I know I've mentioned I've had a little bout of skin cancer where they were able to cut out. I did a whole video on it in case you're interested. Make sure to get checked, wear sunscreen, all the above. But anyway, so I'm real funny about now going into the sun and funny about sunscreen. And a lot of people have talked about the Super Goop Glow Screen. I got it in Golden Hour, and this is like SPF 40, but it says, let me read it to you. Glow Screen SPF 40 is a lightweight pearlescent formula that hydrates the skin while acting as a luminous makeup gripping primer. SPF hack, this bronze shade also doubles as a highlighter wherever you want an extra little dose of sunshine. So, Golden Hour, there were a couple other shades too, but here is the packaging, and I can't wait to test this out. I'm just going to do a little swatcheroo on my hand so you guys can see what it looks like. But definitely always wear your sunscreen. I used to just lay out in the sun. I need to be better. Okay. And see that? Oh, did I get it too dark of a color? Oh boy, I might have gotten too dark of a color. See that on there? And I have to say, it's not as glowy as I thought it would be. For some reason, I thought that I would put it on and it would be like really like shimmery and glowy, but oh well. This will be good to wear at the beach when you just need like a little bit of coverage. So, picked up the Glow Screen. There's more. All right, what else do I have here? Oh, one of the things I went in for, 100%. When I saw these come out, it took every part of my body not to just buy it right away. I was like, Amber, no, you need to be patient. You need to wait for the sale. And I'm talking about the Rare Beauty Soft Pinch Blushes. You guys, there were so many pretty colors. I didn't know which one to pick. I initially thought I was going to go with Hope, but they didn't have Hope, so I ended up going with Cheer. Now, these blushes are going to give you a little bit of a luminosity, and let me show you. Look at this. You guys, that is stunning. Oh my God, that's so pretty. Do you see that on my hand? Oh my God, it's so pretty. And this is nice because it's like a peachy color. But I have heard some people say, I haven't watched a ton of videos on it, but I've heard some people say that if you have texture, you have to be careful because this blush will kind of sink into the texture. So I'm hoping that's not the case because, you guys, if their blushes are anything like their highlighter formula, it's going to be a home run because I have yet to find a highlighter better than the Rare Beauty. And this is coming from someone, if you've watched my videos from the start, I was obsessed with highlighters and I love the Rare Beauty, and I was just so excited for these blushes. I love a glowy blush, so that is so pretty. I mean, look at the shimmer in the packaging, so beautiful. So I picked that up. That was something I knew for sure I was gonna go with. Okay, now speaking of highlighters, this is one that I actually didn't plan on getting when I went in the store, but I was just perusing. You know how you're wandering in Sephora and then you come across things, you're like, oh, that's pretty. So I actually swatched all of these and I'll put an insert. It is a highlighter by Sephora Collection. Now Sephora Collection for the sale, you can get 30% off. So I thought I would try this. I ended up picking Sparkling Honey, which is O2, but when I swatched this, it looked really, really pretty. So let me show you. Now, is it going to be as pretty as Rare Beauty? The jury's still out, but you can see that. I hope I didn't get too dark of a color. Amber, darn it. Always thinking you're tanner than you are, but that is really pretty. You see that? Hopefully that will focus so lovely. But this is one of those things that I was just like, ooh, ooh, and I added it to my basket. And it was Sephora Collection, got 30% off. These are already priced well, so got that. Definitely check that out if you're looking for like an affordable highlighter. I mean, this is pretty. There was another highlighter that I swatched, and I'm gonna insert an overlay, but it seemed like it would be a little too dark for my skin, so I didn't end up getting it. But I felt like it was the right shade, I probably would have gotten it. Okay, and then the final item that I have, and this is like the first thing I added to my cart. I've been wanting this for months, but I wanted to wait and like hold off. And it is the Makeup by Mario Master Mattes, the neutrals. So he had his initial neutrals palette, but those are more warm toned. And I love my cool tones, but this one looks so beautiful. So again, this one is all of the mattes. Oh, look at those cool tones, so pretty. I love this. So I love like neutral eyes. Like actually the one I have on my eyes today is a palette that I picked up in the last Sephora sale and I still use it. It's the Natasha Denona palette. That's another one I would recommend. That has mattes and it also has shimmer, so that's a good one. But I wanted just like a matte palette. You can see that's so beautiful. So I'll probably use these mattes and then I'll put like a sparkly shimmer. I really like the Tarte Chrome Paint Pot. That's really good. But this is so, so pretty. So let me just swatch one. I'm gonna swatch this one right here, which is like the grayish. You see that? Ooh. Okay, let's see how this does here. Very pretty and pigmented, but you know what? That does not surprise me because Makeup by Mario is amazing. Fun fact, I don't know if you guys know, you will if you've been with me for a long time, but I actually went to New York City when he did his masterclass. It was one of his first masterclasses when he was actually doing Kim's makeup, so I got to see him do Kim's makeup live, and he's so relaxing to listen to, and I would like pay so much money to have him do my makeup because I feel like I would just fall asleep in the chair. But he was amazing. So I had no doubt that when he came out with a makeup line, everything would be good. And I am really, really excited about this. So there you have it, you guys. I would say that was a pretty good first haul. I'm really excited about the items I picked up. There were a couple things I went in for that my Sephora did not have, but I am going to another Sephora tomorrow, so hopefully I might see some of those things and they'll have them in stock. So stay tuned, because if I do pick anything else up, I definitely will share. But I will say, all of these products, the Rare Beauty, the blush I'm excited about, the perfume I'm excited about, the glow screen I'm excited about, but it wasn't as glowy as I was thinking. But maybe it's not supposed to since it goes all over your face, but I was thinking it would be more like a shimmery highlighter, but maybe I have to try it out. But this, you guys, let me zoom you in for a second. Let's zoom you in. Okay, we're gonna put more on because more is more. Look at this. I love the smell, and look. I am in love with this. You guys, you might recall, I just bought the Huda Beauty like faux filter lip gloss, and that one was really good, but it was a little more goopy. This is not goopy. I think this is gonna be like my new favorite. I'm so excited. If you're looking for a new gloss, this one. I have it in shade Velvet, but so pretty, right? Love it. Okay, but there you have it, you guys. That is everything I picked up. Like usual, I will be sure to link everything down below, so make sure to check the description box. I will also use, they have a product feature on YouTube where you can link the products on the screen, so I'll try to do that as well for you guys. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new to my channel, make sure to hit that little subscribe button, and I would love to have you follow me on Instagram as well, and let me know, what are you picking up from the sale? I could always use some more recommendations because I'm going in there soon, and I'm sure that I will be making a couple more trips because, you guys, when 20% comes around on a lot of these products like Gucci and Giorgio Armani, and that's the thing, my Sephora doesn't even have Gucci. Sephora I'm going to tomorrow does, okay? There are a lot of brands that they have that I don't have at my Sephora. I always end up getting myself in trouble, and like I walked up to the counter and I put my little basket on there, and I'm like, you know what? I come into this place and I just kind of black out. I'm like, oh, this is nice. But I am proud of myself because, you guys, I thought I would be getting another highlighter. Oh, that's what I'm going to tell you. So I went in there thinking I was going to buy the new Fenty Beauty highlighter. I swatched it and it was pretty, but it still didn't really compare to the Rare Beauty Mesmerize that I love. So I'm like, well, I don't want to spend the money on that. And then I went and I saw this one, and this one was a little more affordable. So I'm sure the Fenty Beauty one is good, but it just didn't blow my socks off for the price. So let me know your thoughts if you pick it up. But anyway, I'm finally ending it now. Thank you guys again for watching. I will see you in my next video. Bye.